These are my service in Vietnam medals with stars and valor.
Dale Madrishin is one of 76 Tampa Bay veterans called to duty one last time for Mission 49. The honor flight of West Central Florida sending this group of veterans at no cost to our nation's capital to commemorate their service and visit the war memorials many have never seen. As each veteran boarded this flight, some painfully recalled how awful they were treated when returning home from the war.
I got off the plane in California, got eggs thrown at me, brought it tomatoes, lettuce. I mean, they were just pelting us something terrible.
We were spat at, we were cursed at. We were called baby killers.
Others remembered some of the horror on the battlefield.
I can't explain the emotions or the feelings that you have when you're watching people be blown up like a balloon pop or like a bomb being dropped in the middle of a group of troops. So it's pretty hard to even talk about it. And I don't talk about it very often.
James J.C. Witt served in the Korean War as a forward observer and tank battalion. He was a young man then, and today just happens to be his 91st birthday.
I can't express my gratitude for being able to serve and my regrets that I'm not able to do more.
How many years?
47. And I only knew her 23 days, including the honeymoon.
We also met the only husband and wife military couple on this mission, Mario and Melanie Ann Gutierrez, who both served in Vietnam. Melanie a nurse, Mario in the Air Force.
I want to see the Vietnam.
And I have some buddies of mine, their names are on the wall.
Right here, Red, come on up.
Once on the ground, we met veteran Delford Connell, turning 100 years old in just weeks, but still sad that most of his battle buddies are now gone.
The guys I looked up to, they're all passed for me through the war. I feel pretty much alone, you know?
Connell served in the Navy during World War II, and during our first stop at that memorial, he was reminded of those he lost.
All my big friends, when I was a senior, see, I didn't get on active duty until 43 of December, and all my heroes were gone. That's what made me enlist.
Another veteran of the Greatest Generation was so overwhelmed with emotion, it became difficult to speak.
What's it mean to be here now? Have you ever seen the memorial?
First. Nope.
We're done.
Okay, all right. It's hard, huh?
Breaking me up.
They also got to see the Tomb of the Unknown and the changing of the guard. Arlington National Cemetery is the final resting place for more than 400,000 veterans. Looking out over the rows and rows of head markers, there's an overwhelming sense of pain and understanding that this is what sacrifice looks like.
Thomas Lawler. There it is.
The Vietnam Wall, with names of over 58,000 servicemen and women, was a memorial veteran Gary Stone needed to see. He served in the Air Force during the Vietnam conflict and wanted to honor his friend who never made it back home.
When you see his name, what goes through your mind and your heart?
Makes you cry. He's a, he shouldn't have been lost. You know, it's a war that was hated. It makes me feel good, though, that I'm here and I get to see his name. I'm very thankful for that.
Gary also finally felt recognized for his service in Vietnam.
We didn't have the hurrah that soldiers get today. So this whole trip to me is very important. I'm sorry. Because it means that I'm being honored this time. And I appreciate that very much.
The carnage that we had to see. Oh, God, it was just terrible. It was terrible. I would not want that on any human being in the world.
Dale Madrishin also served in the Air Force during Vietnam and lost 27 comrades. His service dog, Kai, from Canine Partners for Patriots, helped him stay calm while he got the closure he needed, seeing some of his friends' names on the wall.
I have seen actual proof of where they're at, you know, and they could not ask for a better place to be than the small portal.
An emotional moment of heartache, but also gratefulness for their service and sacrifice.
So much. Okay, thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you for your service and all you do.
Each veteran gets paired with a guardian to help every step of the way.
To spend a day with one of our treasures and one of our heroes is just an absolute honor.
This is Mary Jo Galliman's 7th mission, volunteering as a guardian for the last 2 years.
I just love spending the day learning about these veterans and seeing the memorials and seeing it through their eyes and honoring these veterans.
But the respect and admiration for all these veterans wasn't over just yet. On our flight back home, an old ritual announced on board.
Good evening, everybody. It's Mark. We have one more surprise for you. Mail call. When you hear your name, raise your hand. We have an envelope of mail for you.
A large envelope filled with cards and letters from family, even strangers, to thank these veterans for protecting our freedom. And it brought many to tears.
I am incredibly thankful for you. Without your hard work and dedication, this country wouldn't be the same at all.
Oh, stop it. I used to never cry.
Then upon landing, one last surprise. A welcome home party for these heroes, with over 500 volunteers, even little ones, with a long overdue thank you for serving our country.
Welcome home.
Oh my goodness.